Welcome to DataVis DevTalk. I'm your host, Minhaz Kazi, developer advocate for Data Studio. In this episode of DataVis DevTalk, you'll learn how to manage versions of your connector code and how to use separate deployments for your connector. Let's get started. As you develop code for your community connector, you can test and use your connector in Data Studio by deploying it from AppScript. Deployments let Data Studio execute the connector code via AppScript. You can access and manage all deployments for your connector by going to the Publish menu and selecting Deploy from Manifest in the AppScript environment. After selecting this option, you'll see the list of all available deployments for your connector. For a new connector project, you'll start with the head deployment. This head deployment will always be associated with the current or latest version of your code that you're working with. Click on any deployment to reveal the deployment link. You or your users can use this link to directly access and use your connector in Data Studio. If you go to your deployment link, it will open up your Data Studio with your connector selected. If this is the first time you're using a connector, Data Studio will ask for authorization for that connector. This is where you can start testing your connector. The other way to test your connector is to view the deployment list in AppScript and get the ID for a deployment. Next, open up Data Studio in your browser tab and go to Data Sources. Start adding a new data source and click on the developer's icon on top right. This will give you an interface where you can enter the connector ID, validate the deployment, and then select the connector to start using it. This method is helpful to evaluate how your connector card might look like in the Data Studio connector gallery. I mentioned earlier that the head deployment is always associated with the latest version of your connector code. AppScript lets you save different versions or snapshots of your code. These snapshots are numbered sequentially, and you can add your own notes to each version as you make the changes. Let's say you're developing a connector and you want a few colleagues to try it out. However, at the same time, you want to keep working on the code. So you save a new version of your code, we'll call it test candidate 1, and create a new deployment based on this version. We'll call this deployment test. This test deployment will have a different deployment ID and deployment URL compared to your head deployment. After your colleagues try out your connector, they give you some feedback and you update your code. This new version of the code is now called test candidate 2. Now you want to integrate these changes into the test deployment so your colleagues can view the changes. You don't have to create a new deployment here. You can just edit the existing test deployment and select the new version of the code to use. Having multiple deployments and the ability to update the version of the code associated with each deployment helps you to have a streamlined deployment process. We strongly recommend that you use the head deployment only during code development. Use separate test and production deployments for testing and distribution of your connector. There are a few things to keep in mind for deployments. First, connectors in Data Studio are associated with unique deployment links. So if you create two deployments from your connector code and add them to Data Studio, they will appear as two separate connectors. Second, you can edit and update the name for the deployment and the version of the code associated with the connector, but you cannot edit a deployment ID or a link. And third, if you delete a deployment from AppScript, it cannot be recovered. Let's say your users are using a specific deployment and have created dashboards from it. If you delete the deployment from AppScript, the connector and the associated dashboards will stop working. To learn more about deployments and versions, check out the links in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to the GCP channel for more great content on Data Studio. Thanks for watching, and until next time, keep building awesome dashboards.